Welcome friends in yet another lesson of D.El.Ed program course code 502 unit 11, which is on ICT in learning. Today's lesson is on planning for ICT integration in classroom transaction. But before going on the lesson, I would share with you the expected flow of the lesson. In the beginning of the lesson, I would share with you a lesson guide. I would also spell the expectations in terms of learning objectives and learning outcomes. Then we will discuss the ICT, we will introduce, we will discuss its concept. Then we will go on ICT tools and digital technologies. We will have an expression on ICT integration, its meaning and conditions. We will discuss stages in ICT integration, and we will also discuss the systematic model to plan ICT integration. At the end of the lesson, I will recapitulate all the things which we will discuss in this lesson, and there is a take-home task. The guide of the lesson is presented in front of you. During the presentation, I will explain all the different concepts in detail. You need to attend my voice and the slides as well. You will find important words, sentences, and different things have been highlighted for your attention by me. I have also put a summary at the end for your attention. There are some questions and exercises in between and at the end of my presentation. You must attempt these questions and exercises after going through this video lessons. Now, here are the learning objectives or learning outcomes for you. After this lessons, you will be able to explain the meaning of the term ICT, that is information communication technology. You would be able to identify different ICT tools and techniques. You would also be able to enumerate the stages in ICT integration, and you would also be able to enumerate the systematic model to plan ICT integration. Now, before defining ICT and before going on the actual concept, let me ask a question from you. How would you bring the real life or the life into your class? I think your answer would be through simulation. And how those simulation would be facilitated? Your answer would be through ICT. My friends, if we conceptualize ICT, ICT can be defined as a generic term. Generic terms means which doesn't have a specific meaning but includes many things into it. ICT includes technologies which are being used for collecting, storing, editing, and passing information in various forms. For example, internet, computers, cameras, each and everything which you can understand or which you can recall, which can be used for collecting, storing, editing, and passing information in various forms. Now, the information and communication technologies emerges from the combination of two technologies. One is information technologies, which is popularly known as IT, and one is communication technology, which is popularly known as CT. When we combine IT and CT, we have ICT. IT can be defined as use of electronic equipment for storing, analyzing, and sending information. However, communication technology can be defined as the process of sending, receiving, and exchanging information. IT and CT, when combines with each other, we have ICT. It means ICT, we can use electronic equipment for storing, analyzing, and sending information, as well as receiving information. Now, we talk about ICT integration. What we mean by ICT integration? ICT integration in instruction can be defined as a process of using ICT tools in teaching learning to enhance students' learning. The focus in ICT integration in teaching learning should be on whenever we are integrating ICT in learning, we should have focus on that learners should be enabled through ICT integration to search relevant informations, to retrieve relevant informations, to decode informations in various forms, and also to critically evaluate information of different fields of knowledge. Therefore, it can be said that while we are integrating ICT into instruction, our focus should be on development of HOTS. What is HOTS? HOTS is high order thinking skills, which is a term emerged from Bloom's taxonomy, and HOTS consists of following skills. The skills to remember: whenever we are integrating ICT to instruction, we should have focus on that it should facilitate remembering or the knowledge component of our learners. The skill to understand whatever they are learning or whatever they are gaining from the integration of ICT should be understandable or should facilitate their understanding in terms of the concepts, its meaning and different things also. Then another skill which is there in HOTS is the skill of application. Whatever they have learned, whatever they have remembered, whatever they have understand, they should have the ability, or their ability should be facilitated to apply that particular knowledge in real life situation. Another skill in HOT is the skill of analysis, which is going a step further from the skill of application, that is breaking our knowledge into parts and looking at the nitty-gritties of the knowledge. Then is the skill of evaluation, that whatever knowledge we have gained, we can evaluate it in terms of its use, in terms of its relevance, and in terms of its noviceness. Then the next skill under HOTS is the skill of creation. Whatever knowledge a learner should have, we should focus that ICT integration should facilitate the skill of creation into it, that is the knowledge, on the basis of the knowledge they had, they could create a new kind of knowledge. Therefore, it can be said that integration of ICT should facilitate the efficiency, effectiveness and innovations in teaching learning. Beyond these three objectives, if we are not fulfilling these three objectives, we should not integrate ICT to our teaching learning situation. Efficiency means performing a task within a small time, within minimum time. Effectiveness is defined in terms of the quality of the output or the quality of the task, and innovation is what is new in that particular thing which we have provided to the learners. So these three basic objectives should be fulfilled whenever we are thinking of integration of ICT to our teaching learning process. ICT integration should also ensure learners' engagement at multisensorial level, that is through ICT we should provide different kind of inputs to them which can be processed at different sensorial level. So we can provide multi-sensorial exposure to our student through the integration of ICT, which should be our focus. The integration of ICT should also facilitate active learning. Our learner should not be passive while learning through the integration of ICT. They should get engaged into different kind of activities if we are integrating ICT to our teaching learning. We should also facilitate through ICT integration the cooperative learning. That is, we need to build a student versus student relationship and a student-teacher relationship through the integration of ICT. It is also required to build a student and the world relationship at a level if we are integrating ICT to our teaching learning. Then we should create opportunities for communication also if we are integrating ICT in teaching learning. That is, a student can communicate with other fellow students, student can communicate with the teacher, with his parents, outside, with his relatives or her relatives, or with the world in which he or she is living. ICT integration should also promote motivation amongst the learner. In short, we can say that through ICT integration, we need to achieve the pace in learning along with maintaining its quality. There are different tools which could be integrated in teaching learning, and these tools are multimedia PC, which we commonly use, laptop, notebook, CDs and DVDs, digital videos, like I am recording a video for you and you are getting exposed to this video. This kind of thing is called digital video, which you can see online on your television, or you can have afterwards, watch this video afterwards. Then there is a still camera. Other ICT tools includes internet and its tools such as email, browsers, websites, search engines, charts, social networking, etc. Then we are having as ICT tools the computer aided instruction, which is popularly known as CAI, and computer mediated videos or audios conferencing. Then we are having as ICT tools the digital libraries, e-books and electronic publications. Basic ICT tools can be categorized in four categories, such as informative tools, situating tools, constructive tools and communication tools. Informative tools are to provide information or for information provision. Then there are situating tools. Situating tools are the tools which provides for games, simulation, etc. They help us in bringing near to direct experiences into the classroom. Then there are constructive tools. Through constructive tools, we can construct something, we can manipulate or visualize the knowledge in the classroom. Then there are communication tools. Through communication tools, we can facilitate communication of ideas, information and knowledge. Coming on different digital technologies which could be considered under ICT integration, we are having word processing. Word processing includes docs, yani documents, notes, projects, assignments, etc. Then there are spreadsheets. Spreadsheets are used to record examination scores and also to teach mathematics and to learn mathematics. Then we are having database. Database is just like information storage, where we can store a number of information together. Then we are having graphic softwares. Through graphic softwares, we can visualize and manipulate different things into the classroom, and we can facilitate the quality of learning experiences of our student. Then there are multimedia kits. Then there are games and simulations through which we can make learning fun and joy. Then obviously we are having internet as digital technique to be used, on which we can give online tasks and we can facilitate online learning. My friends, there are certain rules which need to be followed if we are integrating ICT. We should ensure while integrating ICT into the teaching learning situation that our students should have confidence in using computers. If they are not that confident in using computers, they will lose their interest in the learning. They should also have the ability to use graphics, simulations, modeling, etc. properly. Here, the use doesn't mean that they are having sophisticated knowledge or advanced skills in use. Rather, they are comfortable with the use of graphics, simulations, and modeling, etc. They are familiar with these, the nitty-gritties of these things. They are also required to be familiar in using the communication through computers. They should have the awareness of change in the nature of learning due to ICT interface, as it no longer remains the traditional learning. As a teacher, we should also make our student feel responsible for their own learning. Now, coming on the stages in ICT integration, the ICT integration passed through the four basic stages. In first stage, which is called discovery stage, we discover the ICT tools, journal functions and their uses. For example, what is computer, what is mouse, what is different kind of documents, or what are the components of MS Office. In discovery stage, we try to explore the different things around us which could be integrated in the teaching learning situation. Then the second stage in ICT integration is application stage. Application stage connotes to the exploration of how different ICT tools can be used in general and in particular. For example, if I want to teach a language to my student, what kind of ICT tools I can use? If I want to teach mathematics to my student, what kind of ICT tools I can use? And if I just want to make my lesson more enjoyable, more lively, then what kind of ICT tools are there to be used? So in application stage, we explore how different ICT tools can be used. Then there is an infusing stage in which we start recognizing the situation where ICT can be used and its use can become helpful. My friends, we cannot integrate ICT everywhere. We need to think over it judiciously that where we can integrate ICT and enhance the quality of our teaching and students' learning. The fourth and the last stage in ICT integration is transforming stage. In transforming stage, we transform the learning situation through ICT. It means we transform the traditional teaching learning into a yet another new learning situation through the ICT interface. Now the question comes that how to plan for ICT integration. We are having different kind of models for ICT integration. We are having iCare, we are having Assure, but here I would discuss with you the systematic model of ICT integration. Systematic model has 6 stages into it. The first stage is the problem statement stage. In problem statement stage, we clearly define the context or the situation or the problem which needs to be resolved in terms of its learning goals. The example is, if we are trying to devise a plan of conservation of energy by India in future, we need to define it clearly in terms of what goals we are trying to achieve through its learning. The second thing which is there in systematic model, which needs to be done by a teacher while planning for ICT integration, is clearly chalking the learning objectives. Learning objectives connotes to the clear definition of learning outcomes, and there is an A, B, C, D model to be followed to define learning objectives. A connotes to the audience, B connotes to the behavior, C connotes to the condition, and D connotes to the degree. Audience, whom I am focusing. Behavior, what kind of change I am expecting in my learner. C, conditions, what are the conditions imposed to learning, and D, degree, connotes to what extent I need the change in behavior or I am planning for the change in behavior. The third thing which is required to be considered while planning for ICT integration is what kind of technology we need to be integrated to teaching learning situation. Therefore, the third point is what kind of technology required. Keeping in view the problem and learning objective, we can select the suitable technologies which can be integrated in the teaching learning situation. The fourth point in the planning of ICT integration is rationale for using technology. We need to clearly give a justification of what is needed to be selected and what value addition will be done by the integration of the selected technology and how the selected technology can support the instructional processes. The strategies for implementation is the fifth thing which is required to be considered while planning for ICT integration. Strategies for implementations tries to answer the following question, that is, how the selected ICT tool will bring the change in action. Also, the planning for probable diversions we need to do while planning for ICT integration into teaching learning situation. The sixth and the last point in planning for ICT integration is reflections and further suggestions. In reflections and further suggestions, we answer the following questions. The first question is, how far we have succeeded in integrating ICT into teaching learning situation? The second question would be, what else is left to be done? We need to answer that what is required to be done additionally. The third question is, which we are required to answer by planning ICT integration into teaching learning situation is, how the consequent actions can be improved. Additionally, we can ask and we can explore the answers of the following questions also. Is all the desired goals achieved and to what extent while reflecting and providing further suggestions? The technology supported the instructional processes or not? Is the rationale for using technology was sound? Can the implementation process be further improved? Are the methods for students' assessment valid? How can we further improve the use of ICT in the topic? To quickly look through the systematic model of ICT integration, we can say that it starts with the planning of the objectives needs to be achieved and finishes at the feedback process, in which we try to define that whether we have succeeded in our efforts of technology integration and bringing quality into the teaching learning situation or not. ICT integration have different benefits. ICT integration could ensure flexibility in learning. Different learners have different learning styles, and according to their learning styles, we can provide them learning inputs, and similarly, they can reciprocate to those inputs in their own pace. ICT integration also ensures enrichment of learners' experience and cause greater maturity amongst learners. Through ICT integration, we can provide them variety of experiences, and these variety of experiences also bring a kind of maturity amongst learner. Learners tries to explore learning situations on their own, which makes them more mature and independent in terms of acquisition of learning. ICT integration also facilitate assessment of both process and the product, like how we have proceeded and what is our product can be evaluated through ICT integration on the spot itself. ICT provides us variety of learning and assessment instruments through which we can judge the performance of our students, different students differently. ICT integration also authenticate learning and assessment. My friends, if our learners explore the learning situation on their own, they can have much more authenticated learning, and also we can bank on their performance results which we are getting from the ICT. Therefore, the ICT integration ensures active involvement of the learners and also make learning more stable. To sum up, in today's lesson, I have discussed why ICT integration should be done in teaching and assessment. The ICT as a concept was also attempted to be clarified. It was found to be the combination of information technology, that is IT, and communication technology, that is CT. The four categories to which ICT tools belongs were also discussed. These were category of information tools, situating tools, constructive tools, and communication tools. There are different stages in planning for ICT integration, and systematic model which insists on the structure planning could bring better results for integration of ICT in teaching and learning. My friends, this is not the end. I have a take-home task for you. You are required to take a topic of your own choice and plan for ICT integration to teach that topic to your student. With this, I will say you goodbye. We will meet in next video lesson. By then, thank you and bye-bye.